How did Shehla Rashid, the fierce Modi critic, become a Modi fan? आपने कहीं बोला कश्मीर इज नॉट गाजा. Why did you think of that parallel at all?
This NCPDP combine, they had turned Kashmir into Gaza.
Did Shehla change? Did the facts change? Did Mr. Modi change? Who changed?
The situation in Kashmir changed.
Who are you hoping will form government?
I respect Umar Saab. I think he's the only gentleman in Kashmiri politics.
Let's take you back to JNU. Shehla Rashid, Kanhaiya Kumar, Umar Khalid. How do you look back at that evening that led to everything that happened subsequently? Shehla, you have said that the first time you were conscious of being a Muslim, because before that you used to identify as a Marxist, a Ambedkarite, a Kashmiri, but the first time you were conscious of being Muslim was the day Narendra Modi became Prime Minister for the first time in 2014. You were a ferocious critic of Mr. Modi. You looked at him through the lens of the Gujarat riots. You saw him as anti-Muslim, and you have used all manners of phrases for him, which I don't have to go into, but they're a matter of record.
Right.
How did that Shehla Rashid, who looked at Mr. Modi a certain way in 2014, in 2024 describe him to be a selfless leader? How did Shehla Rashid, the fierce Modi critic, become a Modi fan?
Thank you for the question, Barkha. So first of all, I made no secrets of it that I was an anti-Modi, anti-BJP activist, and one of the most outspoken ones.
Indeed. Correct.
And it's not just me. A lot of people were very upset over the Gujarat riots. However, as of 2022, the courts have repeatedly upheld the clean chit that was given to Prime Minister Modi in the Gujarat riots. So when somebody is exonerated by the judiciary or cleared or not convicted, not accused, then we have to also respect that. Now we, and I still refer to myself as, when I say we, I mean in the left progressive ecosystem.
Do you still identify as a leftist?
Absolutely, because like they may not see me that way.
Yes.
But that's how I see myself.
Okay.
So when I'm saying we, I mean the left progressive ecosystem. When one of us, you know, when one of our activists or something is accused, then we will say ki he or she is innocent until proven guilty, right? So we have to hold our opponents to the same kind of standards. So for our opponents, we can't say guilty until proven innocent, and even after being proven innocent, they are guilty.
But let me ask you like this. Did Shehla change? Did the facts change? Did Mr. Modi change? Who changed?
The situation in Kashmir changed. I don't think I have changed. Even today, if you look at my endorsements of Mr. Modi, it is not on every single thing. It is only on those things which were my concerns.
What do you admire the most about him, and what do you continue to disagree with him on?
What I admire most is the steps that Prime Minister Modi took in Kashmir, which at that time we opposed with all our might, right?
Yeah.
No secrets about it. But the results that they've yielded, and it's a utilitarian position, as I've repeatedly said, it has maximized the lives saved. You know, even PM Modi's bitterest critics today, they are forced to concede the point that the security situation in Kashmir has improved. There is no stone pelting. Youth are not losing their lives to stone pelting and then firing and that whole cycle. I mean, you've reported so extensively on it. You remember how it was like what it was like at that time. Like 3 years of my college out of 4 years were just taken out. Yeah. Our children couldn't go to schools. Businesses couldn't do, you know, they just couldn't function because every other day there would be a hartal. Courts couldn't function because at that time you had something called a High Court Bar Association, which was, you know, aligned with, I think it was officially aligned with the Huriyat. And they used to give a call for hartal or whatever every Friday.
Yeah.
And because of that, people were denied justice. So, you know, sometimes you need drastic steps and I don't think anyone else could have done it.
Why do you call him selfless? आपने उनके बारे में कहा और अमित शाह के बारे में भी कहा कि ये selfless हैं दोनों.
Because they've taken so much attack from people like me, from my friends, for taking. So when you call something a bold step, why is it a bold step?
Because it's risky.
It's risky. It upsets people. But they've taken those bold steps. And I think now India has a strong national security stance, which all of us have had to align around, right? Like earlier, the things that used to be said, the things that used to be tolerated, they're not tolerated anymore. The red lines have changed. However, the net result of it is maximization of Kashmiri lives saved. So that is my utilitarian sort of yardstick.
I'll come to Kashmir in a little more detail. Sure. But आपने कहा कि आप हर चीज एंडोर्स नहीं करते about Mr. Modi. What is the one thing you continue to disagree with him on?
What is the one thing that I continue to disagree?
कि आपने कुछ देखा सुना?
Many things. For example, GST on wheelchairs. I'll just give you an example. That is one thing that I.
But that's a very policy example. Ideologically, where do you? Yeah. How do you look at the BJP today? Or do you look at the BJP and Modi differently?
Of course, you have to look at BJP and Modi differently.
Why?
Because BJP is a political party and the PM, it's a constitutional position. So he represents the state. He represents all of us, regardless of whether we voted for him or not. So that's one. But what I was trying to say is that, see, when we talk about BJP ideologically, if you want me to like programmatically engage with the BJP, there is a conversation unfolding throughout the world right now. And it's happening in North America, it's happening in Europe, it's happening in a lot of places. What is that conversation? That conversation is about political correctness or what is sometimes called wokeness.
Yes.
And what we see a lot of issues discussed on the right that the left tries to paper over or gloss over. And what does that result? That results in a lot of young people, you know, finding themselves drawn to or swayed towards right-wing ideology. So for the first time, you've got far-right governments in Netherlands, in Italy, you've got Trump. Why is that? Because these conversations, now when I'm referring to it in the Indian context, right? These are difficult, uncomfortable conversations, awkward conversations. They'll make you, you know, squirm in your seat. Mm-hmm. These are conversations, for example, about love jihad and, you know, like conversions or things like, you know, things like orthodoxy in Islam, polygamy and all of that. These are the things that the left does not have the capability to talk about because it upsets them.
You believe in, supporters. Do you believe in this thing called love jihad? I mean, do you agree with the nomenclature?
The nomenclature, I mean, I may not like it. There is a certain element of, what should I say? There's a grain of truth to it, which is why it sticks.
I think the grain of truth is that interfaith love is very rare in India and that there is mostly a pressure on a woman in any religion to take the religion of her husband, just like there's pressure to take the name of her husband. Mm. So I see it more through a patriarchy lens.
Because you're not from a Muslim family. So those of us coming from a Muslim family, we know it and we've known it all along. Like my second cousin, some of them, they married Christian women. Someone has married a, you know, a Hindu woman, whatever, you know, no problem. Like not much of a problem anyway. But if a Muslim woman, like I can't even dare to think that way, right? So
you can't think of dating, loving outside of Islam?
Yes. So there is a social familiar censure on it. Now, I'm not advocating for any particular thing. Kisko kisse shaadi karni chahiye? Eventually, under our constitution, because we don't live under Sharia, we live under a constitution. It's a personal decision.
Correct.
However, stereotypes are stereotypes for a reason and they stick for a reason. Now, on the left, we say ki aap stereotype mat karo, don't stereotype. But on the right, there are these conversations. So if you've seen in the US context, Vivek Ramaswamy's, you know, debates where he differentiates between LGBT and like queer rights and whatever. So he's having those conversations and a lot of youth are getting attracted towards it. Now, for example, I'll give you one example. Okay, all of this is very contentious. It's not easy for me coming from a Muslim background and identifying very strongly with my community to acknowledge this. So I heard Home Minister Amit Shah at one of the news conclaves this year. So, unko kisi anchor ne pucha ki, अच्छा आप बताइए, आप यूनिफॉर्म सिविल कोड की बात कर रहे हैं, राइट? एंड ही सेड दैट व्हेन वी हैव अ यूनिफॉर्म क्रिमिनल कोड, व्हाई नॉट हैव अ यूनिफॉर्म सिविल कोड एज वेल? आई मीन, ही डिडंट से इट इन दोज एग्जैक्ट टर्म्स, ही सेड इट इन अ वेरी राउंड अबाउट वे. ही सेड कि इफ यू वॉन्ट पर्सनल लॉज, अगर आपको शरिया ही चाहिए तो फिर शरिया हर चीज़ पर रखो, फिर अगर आप चोरी करोगे तो हाथ काट दिए जाएंगे. So Hindus have been living under a secular code ever since the Hindu code bill in, you know, four different legislations when it came, 1950s, 60s, ki main baat kar rahi hu. So Hindus have been living under a, you know, secular code. So is it time for Muslims to also voluntarily reform and give up practices such as polygamy and all of that? Because when we don't reform, the government is forced to do it, and then we get all upset about it.
So, you know, personally, as a feminist, I would support a secular family law because I believe that the religious orthodoxies of all faiths actually work to the detriment of women.
Yeah.
And if there is a uniform civil code, you know, there is talk about exempting tribal communities from it. Mm-hmm. There is talk, if you start, no draft has come, so we actually don't know what the central government has in mind.
Yeah, that's right.
But then if you look at Uttarakhand, you know, there is opinion on live-in couples. Mm-hmm. That's not what secular family law is meant to do. Mm-hmm. Even now, in all faiths, mm-hmm. there are traditions, so-called traditions that would change. So this uh-huh. isn't just going to change Islam. And I guess what I'm asking you is, today, do you identify as left of center, right of center, or do these labels now have no meaning for you?
If you talk in context of political parties, there's been a big churn.
Yeah.
And if you see Congress party, Rahul Gandhi especially, in his articulation, he is articulating a far left politics of redistribution.
Yeah.
The left is talking about liberal rights, for example, LGBT rights, freedom of expression, democratic rights,
yeah.
which are not classic leftist demands. These are liberal demands. And the right, the so-called right, which is the BJP, they are doing welfare. So my ideology lies broadly in the welfare economics framework. And that is why I support what the government is doing, right? So this is something that I've said, for example, Ayushman Bharat, Jan Aushadhi Yojana. Now government has come up with a social, this health cover for above 70 citizens. That's welfare economics. So I support that. And in fact, the right-wing supporters, the actual right-wing supporters of the government, they sometimes get upset over it. Ki aap hamare tax ka paisa welfare mein use kar rahe ho, so you're making people lazy. So I think there is a redefinition of political categories needed, which we don't engage with enough. Humne bana liya hai, left
wo labels hai, bana diye hain, ha.
Congress center hai, BJP right hai. It's not like that. You have to look at the, you know, policies and articulation.
Par wo Shaila Rashid jisne 2014 mein bola tha ki aaj main pehli baar apne aap ko Muslim mehsoos kar rahi hoon kyunki Modi ji pradhanmantri bane hain. Aaj us Shaila Rashid ko ye baat चुपती है कि पॉलिटिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ मुस्लिम्स व्हेन इट कम्स टू द बीजेपी इज वेरी पुअर. यू नो, एट वन पॉइंट यू हैवन हैड अ मुस्लिम मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट फ्रॉम द बीजेपी इन द लोकसभा, एंड ये चर्चा चलती है. हाउ डू यू लुक एट इट?
आई वुड लाइक टू साइट दिस लेडी कॉल्ड आमना बेगम अंसारी. शी इज अ रिसर्च स्कॉलर. I think I was listening to one of her podcasts, and you know, but I really didn't have this perspective because I listened to her. She has a Pasmanda Muslim perspective.
Correct.
And it really opened my eyes when I heard it. She said ki dekho ye jo discourse hai na ki hame power chahiye, power mein participation chahiye, it's an Ashraf discourse. Because it is Ashrafs who have either had a share in the power or who have now been denied a share in the power. The bulk of the community doesn't even have education, doesn't have basic amenities, doesn't have like graduates. The graduates' ka percentage is 2.7% in our community. Only 1% of Indian Muslims are in higher education as per the 2022 survey. So power mein to aap, like, these are, if you talk about the Maslow's hierarchy of needs, power is very high up in the hierarchy of needs,
yeah.
which could cater to the upper caste Ashraf Muslims who always had a share in the power.
Yeah.
But the bulk of the community, we've never had any power. We are struggling for the basics. So I think this is a very upper caste perspective. अच्छा, जो अभी तक हमारे MPs आए हैं, उन्होंने कौन सा कमाल कर लिया है? मतलब the Sachar Committee report in 2006, it wasn't an indictment of the BJP. It was an indictment of the so-called secular parties which had been in power till then. तो उन्होंने क्या किया आज तक? So they've, you know, you give someone a ministry. अच्छा, मुझे ही ministry मिल जाए कल. What will I do for the community? That's what मैटर्स.
बट यू नो जैसे अब हम देख रहे हैं कि एक पॉलिटिक्स में शिफ्ट आ गया है. योगी आदित्यनाथ ने बात की कि जो कवर यात्रा निकलती है तो ईट्रीज पे नाम होना चाहिए विच इजिली आइडेंटिफाइज योर रिलीजन. द कांग्रेस गवर्नमेंट इन हिमाचल
has also come up with this
try to ape it, then itna criticism hua that he was summoned to Delhi and he was told ki aap mat kariye. My question to you before I come to Kashmir is, do you have any, you identify with the welfare ideology or the welfare capitalism, as it were, like if I could use that phrase of the Modi government, but do you have any disagreements with their politics on religious minorities?
See, local issues should be resolved locally. And this is something that I say both to the left and both to the right. हमारा क्या प्रॉब्लम हो गया है, मैं सुबह यहाँ पे आई आपके स्टूडियो पे
जी.
मैं चल रही हूँ, मैं एक हिंदू ड्राइवर के साथ आई हूँ, हिंदू गाइस सर्विंग मी कॉफ़ी, नो प्रॉब्लम. ठीक है, सो इंडिया इज़ अ कंट्री ऑफ 1.4 बिलियन, बट इफ़ यू लुक एट ट्विटर एंड इफ़ यू लुक एट अ स्पेसिफिक इको चैम्बर ऑफ लेफ्ट लीनिंग पीपल, यू विल सी मतलब कत्लोगारत हो रही है एकदम मुसलमानों की. So this isn't a, like it's not a cliche, it's true. On social media some incidents are exaggerated. Now something is happening in Kanpur, it should be resolved in Kanpur. We should not make national issues out of it, kyunki agar aapko national issue banana hai. And by the way, this what I found out during this whole discourse was that it was a 2017 Akhilesh Yadav government directive or Mulayam Singh Yadav government directive ki eateries pe naam hone chahiye. To hum bhi to aise hi, hum bhi kahin pe jaise dhabe pe jate hain to us pe likha hota hai Jain Bhojanale, kya kya likha hota hai, Vaishno Dhaba, Muslim Dhaba, Halal Dhaba, to likha hi hota hai. So it's not like such a big deal, but when we politicize, when we nationalize localized issues, that's when it becomes, you know, the whole country gets polarized.
Okay, before we lose ourselves in a Hindu Muslim debate, let's talk about Jammu. Let's talk about Jammu and Kashmir.
Sure.
We are, as we speak to you, in the midst of a historic election. No matter which side of the debate you are on, it's a historic election. 10 साल में पहली बारी इलेक्शन हो रहा है. 370 की स्पेशल स्टेटस जाने के बाद पहली बारी चुनाव हो रहा है. आप उनमें से थी शाह फैसल के साथ. शाह फैसल वॉज ऑफ कोर्स अ मच सेलिब्रेटेड IAS टॉपर फ्रॉम कश्मीर, बट देन यू एंड ही ब्रीफली केम टुगेदर टू फॉर्म योर ओन पार्टी. यू वर पिटिशनर्स अगेंस्ट द एब्रोगेशन ऑफ 370 इन द सुप्रीम कोर्ट. इन द मिडल ऑफ इट ऑल यू बोथ हैड अ चेंज ऑफ हार्ट. ही इज नाउ बैक एज एन IAS ऑफिसर एंड यू हैव विदड्रॉन योर पिटिशन अगेंस्ट 370 का एब्रोगेशन. आपके क्रिटिक्स कहते हैं कि शैला रशीद डर गई, शाह फैसल डर गया, इन्होंने सरकार के साथ डील कर दी, इनके खिलाफ भी स्क्रूटनी होती, बहुत से लीडर्स जैसे जो डिटेन हो गए, केसेस हो गए, दे वर स्केयर्ड दैट समथिंग सिमिलर वुड हैपन टू देम. हाउ डिड यू गो फ्रॉम बीइंग अ पिटिशनर टू विदड्रॉइंग दैट पिटिशन एंड हैविंग अ कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट पॉलिटिक्स ऑन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर?
आई वाज जस्ट ट्राइंग टू बी ऑथेंटिक टू माई सेल्फ.
व्हेन, देन और नाउ?
When I withdrew the petition, okay. I was just trying to be authentic to myself. Kyunki agar main apni personal life mein, if I'm enjoying the freedoms of abrogation and if I am enjoying the peace ushered in by the abrogation and political space mein jaake main logon ko wahi sari cheezein purani bol rahi hoon jisse wo radicalize ho jaye, I think that's being dishonest, which is what all of the politicians in Kashmir are doing right now. They know it really well that they have been able to go to villages to campaign jahan pe kisi mainstream politician ka jana matlab jinko chhota Pakistan bola jata tha, jahan pe mainstream politician nahi ja sakta tha, ye enjoy kar rahe hain freedom.
Matlab ek zamana hota tha ki Anantnag ko Islamabad bola jata tha Kashmir.
Yeah and they could, in the interior most villages they have gone to campaign at night this time. They are enjoying the benefits of it, but they don't want to name it. सो इनको क्योंकि इलेक्शन लड़ना है, अब मुझे तो इलेक्शन लड़ना नहीं है, सो आई कैन बी मोर ऑनेस्ट अबाउट इट, यू नो. सो आई वाज जस्ट ट्राइंग टू बी मोर ऑथेंटिक अबाउट इट.
बट वाज देयर अ टिपिंग पॉइंट, लाइक व्हाट, लाइक डू यू रिमेंबर दैट मोमेंट व्हेन यू सेड टू योरसेल्फ और यू सेड टू शाह फैसल और यू बोथ सैट एंड हैड अ कन्वर्सेशन, यू सेड
नो वी डिडंट, इट वाज सेपरेट, लाइक ही डिड इट सेपरेटली.
ओके, बट डू यू रिमेंबर दैट मोमेंट व्हेन यू सेड टू योरसेल्फ I was wrong about this. वो क्या दिन था, वो क्या moment था, वो क्या realization था?
I mean, it was a process. It's not like I woke up suddenly one day on a whim or on an impulse and, you know, went to the Supreme Court to withdraw my petition. No, it wasn't like that. So after the abrogation, a few things happened at least.
Yeah.
पहले तो वो पूरा internet ban का वो depressing time था, वो सब रहा. ठीक है. उसके बाद लाइक आई माय सेल्फ आई वाज डिप्रेस्ड आई हैड एन इंजरी आई हैड सम हेल्थ इश्यूज
आई व्हेन यू से यू वर डिप्रेस्ड यू वर क्लिनिकली डिप्रेस्ड
I was seeing a therapist at that time.
I'm just trying to be careful, accurate about the words I use. That's the only reason I asked you not to.
I was also taking medication for depression during the whole, like, you know, pandemic year during 2020.
Sure.
And I just, for the first time, I got the luxury, I would call it a luxury, to just sit down and observe things. And, you know, I'd been like a relentless activist. I had been like on the ground like 24/7 without a break. For years. So for the first time, I got a chance to just sit down and read up on things. Because when we are doing activism, we are using information very selectively, right? We don't actually, we use information only through filter bubbles that comes to us. We don't actually read more extensively, right? So for example, on digital public infrastructure. What did I notice during COVID? COVID ke dauran jo hai, cash was stigmatized. You couldn't hand cash to people. People were so paranoid at that time. Lag raha tha cash se hi wo ho jayega corona. To us time pe all the, you know, the hawkers, the street vendors, the rediwalas, how did they survive? They survived through UPI. Because we had UPI at that time. To tab tak mera stance on UPI was so extreme. I didn't even want to get the app because I was believing in some conspiracy theory that, you know, this is Modi trying to get our data or whatever. But at that time, I started using it, right? And I am myself a germophobic. So I was like, okay, well, this is great because like I don't want to swipe my card and whatever, right? So I was just trying to be more authentic about things. Okay, now you come to Kashmir. Kashmir mein again, during COVID, all like gym, wim, sab band ho gaye the because of COVID.
Yeah.
सो हम लोग डल लेक पे जाते थे, हम लोग वॉक वगैरह करने जाते थे. वहाँ पे हम देखते थे लड़कियाँ, मतलब वर्कआउट गियर में, जैसे आपको दिल्ली में दिखेंगे वर्कआउट गियर में लड़कियाँ चल रही हैं. एंड माई सिस्टर एंड आई एंड सम फ्रेंड्स ऑफ आवर्स एंड वी वुड यू नो टॉक अमंगस्ट आवरसेल्व्स दैट दिस इज अ बिग चेंज. अब आपको लग रहा होगा इतना क्या बिग चेंज है, बट दैट्स एग्जैक्टली द पॉइंट. लाइक नाउ वी डोंट इवन रिमेंबर इट.
Yeah.
We don't remember what it was like. The moral policing, the shaming, like if you would just wear jeans, if you would just wear workout clothes, that whole thing changed. Like because of this 335A, 370, they were socially regressive.
Yeah.
And there was a visible change in how women could certainly like move about. I don't know, like it was like some psychological veil was lifted. So that's what it felt like. Acha, then again, पहले क्या होता था, वो जो के एस एग्जाम होता है, यानी कि जे एंड के, जे के पी एस सी कंबाइंड सिविल सर्विस एग्जाम, जैसे आपका आई ए एस होता है इधर, वहाँ पे के एस होता है. के एस एग्जाम जो है वो तो सालों तक होते ही नहीं थे, मतलब ढाई तीन साल तक होते नहीं थे, जैसे यू पी एस सी हर साल होता है. सो फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम आई सॉ इन टू एंड इन अ स्पैन ऑफ टू एंड हाफ ईयर्स थ्री टाइम्स द कंबाइंड सिविल सर्विसेज एग्जामिनेशन वॉज हेल्ड एंड इट वॉज लाइक अ रियली फेयर फ्री एंड फेयर प्रोसेस. And I mean, I appeared in all three of them. I didn't like make it to the final thing. So I was just trying to be more authentic. So if the state is now filling up posts, doing transparent recruitments, you know, without fear or favor, because pehle kya hota tha, pehle there used to be a lot of the sifarish culture in Kashmir. Right. And for the first time, everything got digitized. Everything became more transparent. Everything became more fair. So because I was using all of these things, I was enjoying all of these freedoms. So I think I was just trying to be more authentic to myself. Ab agar main, you know, like traditional politicians, इधर से कुछ और करूंगी, उधर से कुछ और बोलूंगी, लोगों को बोलूंगी हाँ नहीं नहीं जी ये तो बड़ा खराब है सिस्टम, बड़ा जुल्म हो रहा है. So like if right now you've covered Kashmir, let me ask you, did you see a disconnect between what people were saying and what politicians were saying?
No, absolutely. I think, in my opinion, 370 is now a thing of the past. And any politician who is saying to the people of Jammu and Kashmir ki hum aayenge to hum isko wapas layenge, wo ya knowingly ya unknowingly jhoot bol rahe hain, ya mislead kar rahe hain, ya rhetorical conversation kar rahe hain. Lekin there are still questions, right? Pehle agar main pehle ki Shehla Rashid ki baat karu, to aapki sympathies kahan thi? जब 2010 की मैं बात करूं, आई रिमेंबर कवरिंग दैट ओमर अब्दुल्ला वाज चीफ मिनिस्टर, देयर वर यंग बॉयज डाइंग ऑन द स्ट्रीट्स
बिकॉज़ देयर वर 110 इन पर्टिकुलर,
बिकॉज़ देयर वर स्टोन थ्रोअर्स क्लैशिंग विद सिक्योरिटी फोर्सेस. मोर देन 100 यंग मेन बॉयज एक्चुअली वर किल्ड एट दैट टाइम, यू नो. सो जम्मू कश्मीर हैज सीन अ लॉट. वेयर वर योर सिंपथीज? वुड यू बिकॉज पीपल लुक्ड एट यू, बीजेपी वुड हैव लुक्ड एट यू कि बीजेपी की जो बेस है, नॉट बीजेपी, बीजेपी की जो बेस है वो तो आपको सेपरेटिस्ट लेंस से देखती थी. वो आपको शायद ये जो फ्रेज है टुकड़े टुकड़े गैंग ऑफ जेएनयू वो आपके लिए यूज करती थी. क्या ये मानते हुए कि 370 has or what Modi's 370 move has changed a lot for the good in Jammu and Kashmir, are there still things that disturb you? For example, the detention of mainstream leaders. For example, the debate around the media in the Kashmir Valley. Parties like the NC and PDP argue that there's been a weaponization of the simple granting of a passport. Ki aaj aap khilaf bole ya 370 ki baat karein to aapko passport nahi milega. You know, as someone who says you're still from the progressive left, do these things bother you?
You've asked a very long question.
I know, sorry.
To answer it in part.
Sorry.
Number one, my sympathies were always with the people of Kashmir, with the young people of Kashmir, especially.
Not with the separatists, because aap shayad pehle bhi unse disagree kar chuki hain.
2008 mein, main abhi college mein hi thi, meko abhi koi social science ki bhi samajh mein nahi thi. I was just in engineering college. I wrote a reflections column aata tha Greater Kashmir mein. So I wrote a thing in that against the separatists, not knowing what kind of a social censure it would, you know, attract. Yeah. Not like I was very naive at that time.
Yeah.
So I wrote a thing, ye kya kar rahe hain, ye kyun ladkon ko bol rahe hain, ye kyun bol rahe hain Muzaffarabad march karne ke liye, inke paas koi road map hai, they'll get people killed. Okay, so my stance was that. Fast forward 10 years, 2018, when I came to Kashmir as a sort of like whom people were looking upon as, you know, somebody who would join politics. So you can see there's a Greater Kashmir headline.
Yeah.
In her first Kashmir debate, Shaila questions separatists. So I asked the same question again in 2018. Why are you asking people to come on the streets? Why are you asking, you know, there's bloodshed happening. You don't have a roadmap. Why aren't you like changing strategy, or like why like this strategy of getting people killed? What it does, it only increases the anti-India sentiment. It doesn't do anything else. It's not going to bring Azadi. It hasn't in 10 years that I saw. And it only increases the anti-army, anti-India sentiment. So even in 2018, I was asking the same question. Fast forward to 2023, late 2023.
Yeah.
I'm praising Modi government for the exact same thing. That cycle of killings and violence and stone pelting and protests. Dekhiye, Barka, our youth don't just belong in hospitals. They do not just belong in jails. They do not just belong in graveyards. Our youth belong in the top corporate houses of India. They belong in government, if that's what they would like to do. They belong in educational institutions. They belong in space science. They belong in art and culture, in the hubs of art and culture. I reject this kind of sentiment that the only good Kashmiri is a dead Kashmiri. Why shouldn't we be ambitious? Why shouldn't we ask for more for ourselves? Because ye log to Z security mein hote hain, ye sare politicians. Inki to matlab Z plus plus se upar security hai sabki. Lekin jab ye radicalize karte hain bachchon ko, तब ये लोग ये नहीं समझते हैं कि उनके पास तो वो दे डोंट हैव दैट लक्ज़री.
आपने कहीं बोला कश्मीर इज नॉट गाजा. व्हाई डिड यू थिंक ऑफ दैट पैरेलल एट ऑल?
बिकॉज़ दोज़ आर द पैरेलल्स व्हिच आर बीइंग ड्रॉन. इफ यू सॉ द स्टेटमेंट अभी, आई थिंक ईरान के लीडर का स्टेटमेंट आया था, where he is, you know,
clubbed the Muslims of India with Myanmar and Gaza, which is ridiculous. That was crazy,
which is also a trivialization of what is happening in Gaza. And around the 2010s, you would remember this, there was a certain, there were these parallels drawn between the Palestinian Intifada and the stone pelters of Kashmir.
In fact, the stone, the image of the stone is a borrowed sort of visual expression from the Intifada, isn't it?
Right. So, I mean, you can say that it has historical roots in Kashmir and whatever, but around the 2010s, this parallel was drawn because armed insurgency and infiltration, those were like, those had taken a backseat. This was the sort of mainstream resistance at that point, you know, stone pelters, young people, all of that. The politicians of Kashmir, this NC, PDP combine, they had turned Kashmir into Gaza. That's for sure. If you
you're saying the NC and PDP have turned or had turned.
देखिए आज तो यूनियन टेरिटरी.
एक मिनट आपने एक बड़ी बात बोली. आपने कहा नेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस ऑफ पीडीपी जैसे पार्टीज ने कश्मीर को गाजा बना दिया था.
बना दिया था. अगर आप
कैन यू एक्सप्लेन व्हाट यू मीन.
2010 में मुझे बताइए आज तो यूनियन टेरिटरी है. आज पुलिस एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन सेंटर के अंडर है. ठीक 2010 में किसके अंडर थी. आई रिस्पेक्ट उमर साहब. आई थिंक ही इज द ओनली जेंटलमैन इन कश्मीरी पॉलिटिक्स. दैट अपार्ट माई पर्सनल यू नो एडमिरेशन फॉर हिम अपार्ट. NC was in control of the police. तब किसने गोलियाँ चलवाई. तब उन्होंने ही चलवाई. ठीक है 2016 में आ जाइए. उस टाइम पे चीफ मिनिस्टर महबूबा मुफ्ती थी. एंड यू रिमेंबर दैट प्रेस दैट इनफेमस प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस विद राजनाथ सिंह जी वेर शी इज आस्किंग द जर्नलिस्ट जाओ जाओ जाके चाय पी यू डोंट आस्क मी यू नो टू मेनी क्वेश्चन. दीज आर द पीपल हु हैड मेड कश्मीर इन टू गाजा. एंड प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी ही हैज क्लियर दिस मेस फॉर अस. ही इज डन अस अ फेवर. अब देखिए अब क्या हो रहा है. ये जो मेन स्ट्रीम पॉलिटिशियंस हैं दे आर कम्पीटिंग टू बी सीन एज सेपरेटिस्ट जस्ट बिकॉज असेंबली का इलेक्शन है. असेंबली भी क्या है जो एक डाउनग्रेडेड असेंबली है. एक सिंपल डाउनग्रेडेड असेंबली इलेक्शन के लिए जिसको ये खुद म्यूनसिपैलिटी बोल के बिरेट करते हैं उसके लिए दे आर विलिंग टू रेडिकलाइज एन एंटायर पॉपुलेशन ऑल ओवर अगैन. देयर रेटरिक इज लाइक सेपरेटिस्ट वाइल द सेपरेटिस्ट द जमातीज दे आर डाइंग टू बी सीन एज मेन स्ट्रीम. दे आर सेइंग हमने तो कभी बॉयकॉट किया ही नहीं. हम तो हमेशा इलेक्शन की सपोर्ट में थे. सो माई फियर इज आपको बहुत सारे लोग मिलेंगे कश्मीर में बोलते हुए. बहुत सारे आप वीडियो टेस्टिमोनियल्स भी एग्जिस्टिंग देख सकते हैं जहाँ पे बुजुर्ग लोग बोल रहे हैं कि क्या है ठीक है चल तो रहा है गवर्नर रूल चलने दो और 10 साल चलने दो. अच्छा बिजनेस मैन हैव सेड दिस टू मी कि हमने तो अभी बिजनेस करना शुरू किया था 30 साल बाद हमने अभी 4 साल बिजनेस किया था. अब यही सेम पार्टीज आएंगी ये लोग फिर से मैस क्रिएट कर देंगी बिकॉज दे आर सेल्फिश. फॉर वन असेंबली सीट फॉर इवन वन म्यूनिसिपैलिटी सीट दे विल रेडिकलाइज एन एंटायर
population. But you know how they say that democracy is imperfect but still the best option we have, right? So ये तो बहुत लोग कहते हैं ना कि भाई हमें तो कोई भी नेता नहीं पसंद. ये तो सिंगापुर जैसे हम बन जाए चाइना जैसे ना. We don't really believe that.
No, for a reason. Democracy is a discredited concept for a reason. But particularly.
But it's still the best concept we have.
Sure, but in the.
What is the better concept than democracy?
In the particular case of Kashmir, my contention is that.
Are you saying governor's rule is better than these elections?
I am saying the double speak has to end. The politicians, you know, this double speak that they do. I lost the train of thoughts. I was just going to say something.
नहीं आप वहाँ पे थे कि ये separatists they are the agenda of the mainstream is separatist and जो जमात है इंजीनियर रशीद हैं अफजल गुरु के भाई हैं they are talking more within the framework of mainstream politics.
Democracy should not be used as a vehicle for the propagation of separatist ideas because Barkha that is what radicalized. Our entire generation, हम 2003 से पी डी पी का रेटरिक सुनते आ रहे हैं ह्यूमन राइट्स ह्यूमन राइट्स ह्यूमन राइट्स एंड देन दे लाइक यू नो गो एंड एलाई विद यू नो बीजेपी हम मतलब जिनको उन्होंने उतना ज़्यादा यू नो ये कर दिया था क्रिटिसाइज कर दिया था. सो डोंट गिव अस दिस यू नो ट्रीट अस बेटर ट्रीट अस एज अडल्ट्स. We can handle the truth. We've handled the truth in 2019 and with a lot of maturity. Achha, one thing, when the Prime Minister recently visited, you know, during the election rally when he visited Kashmir, he gave credit to the people of Kashmir for keeping the peace. He didn't give credit to the, you know, police or army or something. He gave credit to the people of Kashmir because the people of Kashmir handled it very well. They knew that 370 is just a smokescreen. It's a shadow of its former self. Yeah. It doesn't really like give us any great federal autonomy or whatever. So the people of Kashmir actually handled it very well. These people who are coming now and saying, hum 370 wapas layenge and the like, they are infantilizing the people of Kashmir. Treat us as adults. We can handle the truth. We know what the truth is. Kashmiri bahut politically aware hai. Supreme Court ne strike down kar diya. Aap kahan se wapas laoge 370? Talk about municipal issues. Achha, I heard a couple of these, you know, mainstream politicians. They were saying, ye kya hai? Ye toh ji municipal election hai. Kyunki ye toh prince aur princesses hai. Inko kya hai? Inke liye ye bahut, this is below their dignity. Achha, agar municipal election hai, talk about municipal issues. Why isn't one single Kashmiri party talking about dog bites? Dog bites se log nahin mar rahe hai. ठीक है वो भी तो ह्यूमन राइट्स इशू है ना. लाइक कश्मीरीज आर डाइंग एट द एंड. आपने पूछा वेयर आर माय सिंपैथीज आर देयर विद द पीपल ऑफ कश्मीर.
व्हाई डिडंट यू कंटेस्ट द इलेक्शंस.
आई विल कंटेस्ट व्हेन आई एज वेल इनफ लाइक व्हेन आई एम 50 60.
यू थिंक पॉलिटिक्स इज फॉर ओल्ड पीपल. यू थिंक पॉलिटिक्स इज फॉर ओल्ड पीपल.
आई डेफिनेटली डोंट थिंक दैट पॉलिटिक्स इज फॉर people who don't come from dynasty, who don't come from money, who have no infrastructure, like it's really, really difficult.
Which party would you contest from if you would?
I have no plans or sympathies as of now. Like I'm writing books and I'm doing some academic pursuits right now. Once I retire comfortably, after that I'll...
But 2 minutes, aaj jo Kashmir mein ho raha hai, aur main specifically Kashmir keh rahi hu, not Jammu in Kashmir, because this is particular to Kashmir. Jamaat, otherwise a banned group, has backed at least 10 candidates. Afzal Guru, parliament convict, hanged in Tihar, his brother is contesting. You have engineer Rashid, now out on bail in a terror funding case, you know, tying up with the Jamaat in a strategic alliance. Ye kya ho raha hai? Aapki samajh mein ye kya ho raha
hai? What has happened is that India is transitioning from becoming a soft state to what it would eventually like to be,
which
you
is,
know, like a hard state, which we can't call it right now a hard state. But India is certainly taking a clear stance on national security. Ab baaki har cheez pe disagree kar lo, aap hijab ban pe disagree, aapne pucha ki aapka disagreement kis cheez se, for example Karnataka mein when the BJP government did the hijab ban, I was against it. ठीक है, मेरा डिसएग्रीमेंट उस चीज़ पे हो सकता है, व्हील चेयर पे जीएसटी लग रहा है मेरा उस पे, बट ऑन नेशनल सिक्योरिटी देर आर क्लियर रेड लाइंस दैट आर ड्रॉन. पीपल आर नॉट गिवन द लेग रूम टू एनी मोर, क्योंकि पीपल गेट रेडिकलाइज्ड विद वर्ड्स, सो पीपल हैव नॉट बीन गिवन द लेग रूम नाउ टू टॉक अबाउट ऑल दैट, ऑल दोज थिंग्स विच यूज टू बी सेड बिफोर. सो इंडिया इज टेकिंग अ क्लियर नेशनल सिक्योरिटी स्टैंड विच इज ब्रिंगिंग ऑल दीज पीपल to clarify their position, which is compelling these people to clarify their position. And that is what is happening, and all of us are aligning around it. Now, some people might say, you know, they might dismiss national security as a as but an in illegitimate
some, in
concern.
Some logon ko BJP proxies bol rahi hain, jo mainstream parties hain. Wo Jamaat ko, Engineer Rashid ko, in sare logon ko BJP proxies bol rahi hain. शायद आपको भी बोले पर आप चुनाव में नहीं.
मुझे तो मैम, मैं आपको क्या बताऊं, जब मैं 2018 में जब अपने एंटी बीजेपी एक्टिविज्म के चरम पे थी मैं, उस टाइम पे मुझे बोला जाता था कि ये बीजेपी प्रॉक्सी है.
उस टाइम पे भी,
उस टाइम पीपल वुड कम,
व्हाई?
बिकॉज़ दैट इज द रूमर दे स्प्रेड अबाउट यू, यू नो, इफ यू आर नॉट फ्रॉम सम डायनेस्टी, अगर आप डायनेस्टी से हो, यू हैव फुल फ्रीडम टू अलाई विद द बीजेपी, यू कैन फॉर्म गवर्नमेंट विद देम, यू कैन बी अ मिनिस्टर इन देयर गवर्नमेंट. Nobody will call you a BJP ally or a proxy.
Yeah.
But if you are a nobody like myself, like I didn't have any infrastructure, any support from anywhere, I didn't even know anybody in the state or administration. मतलब मैं अपने ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा अपने ज़िले के SSP को जानती थी. That's all. And I was being called a BJP proxy. The only two political parties which have been in government with the BJP, as a matter of fact, are NC and PDP. So who are the BJP allies? How much is spent on their security and accommodation? इनके पास सबके पास Y security, Z security है. They are the BJP. अच्छा, मैं आपको एक बात बताऊँ. आज तो मैं BJP की A team हूँ, समझ लो. I will accept the charge. Like I'm not B team, C team. I am A team of BJP. लेकिन आप मुझे ये बताइए, any party which comes to power in J&K, they will have to work with the center. नहीं तो आप केजरीवाल की तरह चिल्लाते रहेंगे, हमारे अंडर ये नहीं है, हमारे अंडर वो नहीं है. आई वुड एक्चुअली वॉन्ट, लाइक इफ द एनसी डज वेल इन द इलेक्शंस, आई वुड एक्चुअली वॉन्ट देम टू दे विल डिसएग्री विद इट, दे विल नॉट लाइक दिस कैटेगराइजेशन ऑब्वियसली, बट आई वुड एक्चुअली लाइक देम टू अलाय विद द बीजेपी इफ द बीजेपी डज वेल इन जम्मू, बिकॉज वी वॉन्ट बेनिफिट्स फॉर आर पीपल. वी डोंट वॉन्ट डेली का सरदर्द, डेली का रैंटिंग रोना कि ये नहीं है, ये तो हमारे अंडर नहीं है, वो तो हमारे अंडर नहीं है. गवर्न करो यार, बहुत सारे इश्यूज़ हैं. एम्प्लॉयमेंट का इशू है, ट्रांसपोर्ट, वाटर ट्रांसपोर्ट पे कुछ करो, वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट पे कुछ करो, हॉस्पिटल्स के इश्यूज़ हैं, मतलब देयर इज जस्ट सो मच, स्किल डेवलपमेंट पे कुछ करो, अलाइ विद द सेंटर, गेट बेनिफिट्स फॉर आवर.
हु आर यू होपिंग विल फॉर्म गवर्नमेंट?
दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली माई पर्सनल ओपिनियन, डिस्क्लेमर. आई वॉन्ट लाइक एन सी एंड बीजेपी टू फॉर्म द गवर्नमेंट, बिकॉज आई वॉन्ट गवर्नमेंट बेनिफिट्स टू पर्कुलेट टू अस. आई डोंट वॉन्ट डेली का सरदर्द.
व्हेन आई आस्क्ड उमर अब्दुल्ला कि आप पहले कर चुके हैं तो आप दोबारा भी कर सकते हैं फॉर पोलिटिकल सर्वाइवल, ही सेड इट वुड बी द डेथ ऑफ माई पॉलिटिक्स इफ आई टाइड अप विद अ मोदी लेड बीजेपी.
नॉट रियली, बिकॉज इफ दे आर ऑनेस्ट अबाउट इट. अब अगर वो डबल स्पीक करेंगे तो फिर तो डेफिनेटली होगा, बट इफ दे जस्ट कम क्लीन टू द पीपल, यू नो, इट्स लाइक वी कैन हैंडल द ट्रूथ, जस्ट टेल अस द ट्रूथ दैट भाई देखो, अगर हम लोग अलाई करेंगे, दे मे नॉट डू इट, बट दिस इज माई विश लिस्ट, आई डोंट नो, अगर हम लोग कांग्रेस के साथ अलाय करेंगे देन द स्टेट बेनिफिट्स विल नॉट पर्कुलेट टू अस, अगर हम लोग अलाय करेंगे तो देन द स्टेट बेनिफिट्स विल पर्कुलेट
टू अस. सो यू आर सेइंग द अलायंस शुड बी विद हूएवर इज इन पावर इन द सेंटर.
दैट इज हाउ इट हैज ऑलवेज बीन विद कश्मीर. You know,
yeah.
I mean, even before it was a union territory, the center pulled the strings in Kashmir, and like let's admit it, all the Kashmir politicians have always been on a tight leash from the center. So making a secret for aap logon ko bevakoof banaoge, let that era be over. Let that era of double speak be over. But the best thing, if you ask me what the best thing is BJP has done, it has ended the double speak on many issues in Kashmir and, you know, in India also.
You spoke about nationalism and the transition from a soft to a hard state.
Hmm.
Let's take you back to JNU. Let's take you back to Kanhaiya Kumar, Umar Khalid. You advocated for them. You fought for them.
Yeah.
Umar Khalid is still in jail. Kanhaiya Kumar is a Congress leader.
No, Umar was released then.
Ah, us samay.
And then he was arrested.
Sorry.
Again.
Yes, yeah. I'm paraphrasing, but ha.
Yes.
Yes. The allegation at that time that all of you together, you know, if you look at that image of that time, so much, it's a movie. It's a movie script. These three young people.
There were a couple of movies and like an ill-fated web series made about it. Yeah.
But it genuinely is, you look at these three people,
yeah.
Shaila Rashid, Kanhaiya Kumar, Umar Khalid, and the three different paths that life takes them in after what happened at JNU happened. Let's look back at that time. The allegation ki Bharat ke khilaf slogans raised hue, ki tukde tukde slogans raised hue, from which was born this TV phrase, tukde tukde gang. How do you look back at that evening that led to everything that happened subsequently?
It was the most unfortunate thing that ever happened.
In what way?
In a way that we had the upper edge over the government. I'll tell you how. A couple of weeks back, Smriti Rani ma'am, she did a podcast with Sushant Sinha. And usme she recalled this Parliament march, MHRD march that we had done. She was the education minister, so we had marched. And we were very proudly, you know, raising our demands. I didn't think of myself, main Kashmiri hu, main ye hu, whatever, nothing doing. I'm a student's representative. I wasn't thinking in identity terms. And we were on the front foot, fighting the government on issues of fellowship. Acha, aapne ek aur cheez puchi us time, mujhe yaad nahi aayi ki, what are you against? For example, the Maulana Azad fellowships. BJP should restore those, you know.
Jo unhone hatai, haan.
Wo bhi ek point of disagreement. So, sorry, I just like digressed a little
no
bit.
No problem. Huh?
So at that time, when we were running that Occupy UGC movement, you know, against scrapping of fellowships, we were on the front foot against the government. And that whole incident of like those unfortunate whatever was said at that time, that put us on the back foot, that put us in a position of explaining ourselves. Uske baad, JNU में जो स्टूडेंट protests का कल्चर था, मतलब जो सीताराम येचुरी जी के टाइम से आपने देखे, वो अभी दृश्य आपने अभी देखे होंगे जब उनकी when he passed away, कि यू नो ही वॉज लाइक फेस टू फेस विद इंदिरा गांधी जी. दैट इज एग्जैक्टली हाउ वी वर फेस टू फेस विद स्मृति ईरानी. इट टुक अस फ्रॉम देयर टू अ बैक फुट, एंड दैट इज वॉट एनार्किस्ट्स डू. लाइक देयर एक्शंस, आई मीन इट्स अ डबल एज्ड सर्ड. Now you can say, Kishala, you also became famous because of that only,
yeah.
Right? That also happened. Like, we were catapulted to fame without like any, you know, sort of warning.
But there are two opinions on whether anti-India slogans were raised.
Hmm.
Were they raised?
I mean, there were slogans raised.
Against India?
Not by JNU students.
Then by who?
By masked people.
Correct.
People who were wearing masks.
Today, do you think you know who they were?
No, I don't know who they were, but I know that they were not JNU students.
Okay.
However,
so it was not Kanhaiya.
Oh, no, no, no.
Not Umar and not you.
No.
Okay.
Not at all. These were people who had come from outside, you know, who raised those slogans. However, here what I would like to say is that even those slogans and whatever was raised, there were not more than 9 people over there. Okay. But thanks to like Z News and everybody who gave us that major like media blitzkrieg,
yeah.
that huge platform, yeah. Eventually, when like Azadi slogans in the leftist sense of the terms, like when Kanhaiya was released and he raised those slogans, Berozgari se Azadi and everything, thanks to them, we had an audience of like, I don't know, 10 million or whatever. At that time, and Kanhaiya Kumar was trending worldwide on Twitter.
Do you consider Kanhaiya a friend today?
He is a better friend than I am. He's better at keeping in touch than I am. So yeah, like he's been a good friend. Yeah.
The fact that you've traveled in very different political directions.
I did campaign for him in Bihar actually when he contested 2019 Lok Sabha election. So I actually went twice for his campaign.
But not in 24 when he contested.
Not in 24. But I did send him my best wishes and everything.
And what do you feel about the kind of continued incarceration of Umar Khalid?
I just hope that he, you know, gets out. And I just hope that people like him who are very talented and intelligent, their talents are mainstreamed and utilized, you know, for the formation of this Viksit Bharat that we are talking about. For this, we need to be united. For this, we need to channel all of our energies into one direction. Like right now, India is moving forward with resolve. And we need all hands on deck. So I just feel that this polarization should end. This, you know, itna jo extreme ho gaya, aapne thoda sa bhi kuch government ke against bol diya, to ho gaya, aap militant ho gaya, kya ho gaya. I don't know the details of his case.
Yeah.
I just hope that he comes out clean of whatever allegations are there. But I would say that we need to end. That is my whole project, that this polarization should end. We need to move forward together as a nation. Kyunki Barkha, this can be exploited by anyone. Pakistan to kar hi raha hai exploit hamare social divisions kab se. Lekin there is also China. There's also like many other countries, you know, who may not be happy about our rise. Maybe some North American countries. So we need to be united. So I would call for like more unity on both sides.
You spoke about Azadi slogans being raised in a leftist context. And, you know, there's Kamla Bhaseen's rendition of Azadi. There's the Kanhaiya Kumar rendition of Azadi. There used to be... Hum kya chahte Azadi slow separatist rallies in Kashmir Valley, which you don't see today.
Right.
What is Azadi to you today?
So I would use it in the same sense as Professor Amartya Sen uses it, that it is the capacity for personal development. That is what we need to provide for every Indian, every Kashmiri, every Muslim. So there should be enough opportunities for us to develop ourselves personally. There should be avenues, जैसे आप अभी sports में देख रहे हैं.
जी.
Sports में थोड़ा सा infrastructure मिल गया. You see where our kids have reached. Like it's such a matter of pride. And this is the kind of ecosystem that we need to develop for every Indian. And for that, if we need to make more efforts for education, we need to make more efforts.
Do you feel bad that JNU has become such a flashpoint? Just the word, you say JNU, and there are stereotypes associated with it. Even with, you know, the finance minister, Nirmala Sitharaman being from there, Jai Shankar. I mean, there are so many JNU linkages to this government.
Yeah, even Professor Abhijit Banerjee, who's a Nobel winner, yeah, he's from JNU. It is unfortunate, yeah. It is unfortunate because it's one of the best universities and the alleged actions of a few anarchists, they just tarnished this university forever, and the right wing did not lose a single chance to paint that as the stance of the entire university.
What would you want people to understand about JNU?
No, I've been in this role of defending JNU unwittingly since 2016, since the day it happened. Because at that time, I was, you know, I was sort of the acting president. I never called myself that, but I was the acting president at that time. So it was my responsibility to defend JNU despite being a Kashmiri. So I had to keep my personal sentiments aside.
Yeah.
You know, the whole deal was about Kashmir at the end of the day.
Yes, ironically.
So I, as a Kashmiri, I had to keep my personal sentiments aside, and I had to understand, Shaila, you are an elected representative. 1,100 people may have voted for you, but you represent 8,000 people. That includes the ABVP, that includes the neutral people who never vote. That includes all the alumni of JNU. That includes everyone whose name is associated with JNU. So I had and I'm still bearing that burden of defending JNU. I would say even today that whatever those actions, whatever those slogans were raised, none of those slogans were raised by JNU students. And JNU is one of the best universities. It has produced like some of the best scholars throughout the world, who are like in like top positions throughout the world. What I would say is that like more universe, I'm saying this like with a lot of risk, I'll be attacked for this or whatever. But I feel that we should have more centers of excellence such as JNU, because JNU mein, the one thing that differentiated JNU was that every poor child could study there. Every poor student could study sure. there. This is not the luxury that people have. Everyone cannot go to big universities, private universities. Sure. So we need to have a publicly funded university in every district of this country if we have to compete with China and the US. Because you go to the US, there is a university in every street. You go to China, you see Tsinghua University, for example. Jitna hamara pura education ka budget hai, utna Tsinghua University ka akele ka saal ka research budget hai.
Yeah.
To hum compete kin ke saath kare na, hume vision thoda us pe rakhna padega.
Aapne kaha ki hijab ban jab Karnataka mein hua tha, that was one of the things you disagreed with the BJP on. It was the BJP government when that happened. Hijab is a very polarizing issue even in the feminist discourse.
Is it though?
Huh?
Is it though?
It is, because agar aap Iran mein dekhein, to what yes. women have been doing for them, the defiance of the hijab is an assertion.
Right.
In other cultures, the wearing of the hijab is an assertion. Yes. And so I think your cultural context or your political context makes you look at the hijab differently.
Huh.
What does the hijab mean to you? Have you ever worn it?
Oh, yes, yes, of course. I have worn the hijab. I used to be a namazi. I used to pray 6 times a day. I used to do tahajjud, you know, at twilight. So I've done all of that. And that was the year I was a topper. Like I was a state topper that year. Because when you do everything like that, namaz, hijab, distractions apart, you're a very disciplined student at that time. Matlab, between namaz, you are just like solving as many problems as you can. You actually become very efficient. There are no distractions. So my point is, I've experienced it myself. Obviously, I'm a Muslim. But it's not about that. It's about choice. Main aapko bolu, nahin, you cannot wear shirt, aapko kurta hi pehenna hai. You cannot wear jeans, aapko capris hi pehenni hai. It doesn't work that way. Like, we have to allow women. First of all, women ke liye aise hi itna difficult hai education attain karna. Now, you cannot add more
barriers.
Hurdles at the finishing line. You can't do that. And for that, I would... By the way, it was not BJP as a whole. It was one state government. And I think they paid very dearly the price for it. It was a pretty daft... I don't know who came up with this idea. But no, you cannot control. In fact, if I were the education minister or something, I would say just like, you know, do away with uniform and discipline and
just
whatever.
Get girls to school, college.
Yeah.
Like, that should be the priority.
This whole uniform business, I don't hate it. Matlab, that's
why?
Personal opinion. I don't know, it's very boring. People
but
should
it's an
wear.
Equalizer, na? It's meant to equalize classes. That was the idea of the uniform. That rich and poor should not be distinguished. There should be, you know.
Yeah, sure. But I just feel that our focus is elsewhere. Hum log na, we miss the woods for the trees, basically. So, or the trees for the woods, which one is it?
Why did you stop wearing the hijab?
Because I was getting too much, too religious, too much into it. So, I just went down like a rabbit hole and like, I just like realized that like, this is too much. But that's like a later conversation.
Right.
But what I was trying to say is that this whole business of uniform, it's missing the trees for the woods, because we need to focus on education, skills. You must have seen these videos on social media. Jahan pe wo Chinese bache jo hai na, wo dikha rahe hain kis tarah se wo basketball ki practice kar rahe hain and all that. You know, how they are coordinating, what are the ways in which they are learning. Main bhi ek video dekh rahi thi, jis mein wo China mein ek teacher hai, how she is using like 3D technology on the board to show chemical experiments to kids. Matlab, all that is simulation is happening. Yeah. She is doing this, wo chemical usme ja raha hai. That is how they are teaching kids. Focus on that, like forget all this uniform and discipline and whatever, like we need to focus on the real things.
Let's talk a little bit about, and I apologize if this is painful to talk about, you've effectively been raised by a single mother.
Being raised by a single mother has also given me a very different perspective on life.
Yeah.
So for example, this whole sort of idea that we have, no, that males are providers.
Yeah.
And females are recipients. I just didn't grow up
That's
with
right.
it
yeah.
at all. And I never had this thing in mind that someday I'll marry some guy who will provide for me or, you know, something. I always had this thing in mind that my life is my own and like I have to chart my own course. So, you know, should I call it a blessing in disguise or whatever? I don't know. It has made me very independent. It has made me think of myself not as secondary. Because when you see a mother who's working, who's providing for you emotionally, financially, every other way, you don't think of yourself as like a second fiddle, playing as a second fiddle to somebody in a partnership or whatever. No, I think of the nation. I think of my community. I think of larger questions. I think of environment. Because I never learned like playing second fiddle to anybody. I see myself as a, at that time, as a leader. Today, I see myself as, you know, an academic, but like a public intellectual, someone who wants to make contributions to the
Do you and she think similarly or do you disagree?
She, as a parent, she does have concerns. Ki, you know, like, don't too much, zyada mat karo, ye, wo, whatever. As a parent, she has concerns.
Kam bolo, chup raho thoda.
Because no parent wants their children the backlash. To get into trouble. Correct. Yeah, that's for sure. But having said that, she's never stopped me. And I think that's how parents should, like, you know, allow their children to be whatever they want to be. Like, even allow them to fail. Agar acting mein fail hoge to sports mein ho sakta hai acha kar le. Agar journalism mein fail hoge to ho sakta hai filmmaking mein acha kar le. So we have to allow our children to fail also.
Now you have a book that is coming out soon. Inshallah, and it's a book on role models drawn from within the Muslim community. And I know that we've agreed to have a separate conversation when the book comes out. But why this book? Why this book that's speaking about Muslim role models at a time when this is such a polarizing question, the place of India's Muslims, you know, in jisko Western media kehte hai, in Modi's India. Mujhse wo bolte
hai ki, not just Modi's.
You know, when you travel abroad and people will ask you this question, I have my own opinions, but I'll always say it's everybody's India. It's not any one person's India. So this is a media shorthand that I'm not a big fan of. But you know what I'm asking you. Why this book?
So I was trying to say that in the post 9/11 phase, in the post 9/11 world, there is a negative perception of Muslims. No secrets about it. We can try to, you know, paper it over, but it's a fact. There's an anti-Muslim prejudice. There's profiling, like so many celebrities have talked about it, blah, 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 right? So there is an anti-Muslim prejudice. So what I've realized is that we always keep complaining about just the innocence of Muslims, like movie aayi thi. पूरा उस पर पूरी दुनिया में दंगे हो गए मतलब कितनी जाने चली गई YouTube बैन हो गया पाकिस्तान बांग्लादेश में We always just keep objecting. नहीं नहीं इसने हमको क्यों गलत दिखाया इस फिल्म में क्यों हमको टेररिस्ट दिखाया उस बुक में उसने क्यों लिखा आप लिखो ना बुक आप क्यों नहीं बना रहे हो मूवी मुस्लिम कम्युनिटी ने क्या अजीम प्रेम जी पे कोई मूवी बनाई मुझे पता अजीम प्रेम जी ही इज आई थिंक द बिगेस्ट इफ आई एम नॉट मिस्टेकन बिगेस्ट फिलैंथ्रोपिस्ट इन इंडिया मुस्लिम कम्युनिटी से मेरा सवाल है आपने कभी मूवी बनाई मेरा ये सवाल फिल्म इंडस्ट्री से भी है मीडिया से भी है ठीक है लेकिन अगर वो नहीं बना रहे आप करो ना आपको कौन रोक रहा है अगर कोई आपके खिलाफ किताब लिख रहा है आप पॉजिटिव किताब लिखो आप खुद लिखो बिकॉज एन आंसर टू अ बुक शुड बी अ बुक एन आंसर टू अ मूवी शुड बी अ मूवी हम लोग क्या करते हैं वी आर जस्ट पैसिवली सिटिंग हम लोग कोई पॉजिटिव शोकेस नहीं करेंगे अपनी कम्युनिटी का वील ऑलवेज जस्ट कीप कंप्लेन अरे इसने कैसे मूवी बना दी हमारे ऊपर अब हमें इसके ऊपर दंगे करने हैं देन वी आर प्रूविंग देम राइट यू नो वी आर काइंड ऑफ डिफीटिंग द
सेल्फ परपेचुएटिंग
या मतलब लाइक समबडी इज सेइंग दैट मुस्लिम्स आर वायलेंट आप जाके उसको मार रहे हो यू आर प्रूविंग देम राइट व्हाई नॉट शोकेस अ पॉजिटिव साइड ऑफ योर कम्युनिटी योरसेल्फ और मैंने तो मेरी किताब में 15 मुसलमान हैं हु आर एट द टॉप इन वेरियस फील्ड्स बट देयर आर सो मेनी अदर्स लाइक देयर इज उस्ताद जाकिर हुसैन who is the first Indian to win 3 Grammys in a single night.
Yeah.
Right? He's a Muslim. We are not talking about Muslimano ne kaun si film un pe banai. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. He is considered a role model by all Indians, aap manenge, not by Muslims. Hamari community mein jo discussion, kyunki main community se aati hu, mujhe pata hai, hamari community mein kya discussion, arre nahi, wo to actually na, wo Muslim nahi the, wo to budh parast the, wo to Gita Vita bhi padhte the, and all that. Those are the discussions, that is the poverty of civic discourse among Muslims. Ke hum, we cannot talk about his scientific achievements, his contribution to SLV3, aap kisi musliman se pooch lo, APJ Abdul Kalam aur SLV3 ka connection, they'll not know about it, that he was the project director of SLV3. Right? They'll not know about it. We don't have the capability to talk about it. We'll just keep talking about, talk about their work. अच्छा, दिस इज नॉट अ प्रॉब्लम ओनली अमंग इंडियन मुस्लिम्स. पाकिस्तान में प्रोफेसर अब्दुल सलाम बका, ही वॉज द ही इज द फर्स्ट मुस्लिम इन द वर्ल्ड टू विन अ नोबेल. अब चाहे वो अहमदी थे, कुछ आप इनको हिंदू ही बोल लो, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं, पाकिस्तानी नेशनल तो थे ना. यू शुड हैव सेलिब्रेटेड हिम, यू एज इन पाकिस्तान शुड हैव सेलिब्रेटेड हिम. जमात इस्लामी एट दैट टाइम हेल्ड प्रोटेस्ट्स एट कायदे आजम यूनिवर्सिटी. दे डिड नॉट अलाउ हिम टू अटेंड हिज ओन फेलिसिटेशन सेरेमनी. पाकिस्तान कैंसल्ड हिज सिटीजनशिप. सो दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम इन द मुस्लिम कम्युनिटी. We don't own our role models. We berate our role models because they'll talk about reform or they will refuse to talk about polarizing topics. They will refuse to give in to victimhood. So there is a tendency.
But can I hold you there? Where is that balance between not slipping into victimhood, but calling out things that are wrong, right? So if a man is killed on the allegation of storing a certain kind of meat in his fridge, that's unacceptable. Or if an old man is attacked on a train, wohi ki aap beef leke ghoom rahe hain. These cannot be condoned.
We have to call it out. But
you have to call also, it out. Yeah.
We have to also ask ourselves, where is our social capital? Hamara social capital itna kam kyun hai ki we don't even have like a few prominent voices to talk about it. Kyunki pehle to community ne unko disown kar diya hai. Pehle to are nahi nahi iski to biwi hindu hai, ye to geeta padhta hai, to so anyone who is an achiever will always have a pluralist outlook. Our community will disown them. That is why we don't have social capital. So we also have to ask ourselves, why are Muslims only doing this cow wala business? Chhod do cow wala business. जैसे दलितों ने ऊना में एक स्टांस लिया कि हम आज से डेड काउ का कैरकस नहीं उठाएंगे आफ्टर अ लिंचिंग, जब वहाँ लिंचिंग हुई थी. आप भी लो स्टांस कि नहीं जी, हमें बस स्पेस साइंस करना है, हमें हाईटेक करना है, हमें मेडिकल साइंस करना है, हमें इंजीनियरिंग.
वी वुड बी मिस्टेकन इन थिंकिंग और इन परपेचुएटिंग द मिसकंसेप्शन दैट द स्टेट सपोर्ट्स मॉब लिंचिंग. In fact, if anything, it takes away from state power. It is a sort of decentralization of state power. In fact, if you see Prime Minister Modi himself, he had called on more occasions than one these people who engage in mob lynching antisocial elements. And as far as I'm concerned, you're aware that I had run a campaign against mob lynching, and we were asking for a law against mob lynching. And if you see now the new law that has come in, the Bharatiya Nyay Samhita, Section 103, Subclause 2, actually talks about mob lynching. So that demand that there should be a law against mob lynching, that has been met.
So my point is this portrayal of Muslims as either victims or as villains, this has to change, because this makes us self-identify either as villains or as victims. And then the community sentiment also gets mobilized around that only. We are not victims. We are not villains. We are masters of our own destiny. We need to take charge of our own development.
And I'm really looking forward to reading the book. But in the end, let me ask you, have you met with Prime Minister Modi?
No, I haven't.
If you were to meet him, what is the one thing that you would really want to say to him?
I would present my book to him. I'd want him to read it.
I'm sure you'll get a chance to do that.
And inshallah.
And what would you want to say to him? Like, agar aap jaise milte hain na kisi se, to aap pehli cheez kya bolna chahenge?
So, I would like to request him to bring a constitutional amendment, amending articles 14 and 15 of the constitution to include the word disability. So, I know that these articles, they say race, religion, creed, sex, etc. and the like. So, etc. mein disability to ho jata hai, but I want the word disability. Actually, this was my plan, that if I were to become, when I was in politics, if I were to become a member of parliament, my first, because I wasn't planning to be on the treasury benches, I was planning to be in the opposition. So the first thing that I wanted to do on my agenda was to bring a private member's bill, and it would have been a constitutional amendment bill, to introduce the word disability into the, articles 14 and 15, equality and non-discrimination.
And you're still saying that you don't now see yourself in politics till you retire.
Yeah, I want to make some money. I want to work and I want to grow old and then do politics. I think I was a precocious politician. I was too much in a hurry.
We wish you the best and look forward to your book. And we'll have you back one sets out to talk about it. Because
thank you so much.
Right now, I'm forbidden from talking about the books. So we're talking only just a little bit about it.
So
Shaila Rashid, we wish you the very best.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.